So hi, I'm Bob Rocha, Director of Science and Education Programs at the New Bedford Whaling Museum. I'd like to introduce you to one of our new exhibits, the Biology and Behavior section of the overall larger exhibit, Whales Today. This, of course, is my favorite because I helped put this together and I find these animals fascinating and I like finding creative ways to teach about them. So we've put together a lot of tools and exhibit parts to answer a lot of questions people ask. Because when they walk in, the first thing they see are these great skeletons hanging above us. It generates a lot of questions, a lot of curiosity. So we do some of the pretty basic things, like set up this panel here, talking about the basics of whales, dolphins, and porpoises, the fact that some feed with baleen, some feed with teeth, and via echolocation. Another common question, what's the difference between a dolphin and a porpoise? Talk about that there. On the other side, learn a little bit about whale evolution. And then over against the wall, we have a nice set of anatomical puzzles focusing on our four species that hang here. So you get to see them with their skin on. You get to see skeletal view. You also get to see internal organs, all those fantastic illustrations done by a partner of ours on the other side of the country, an illustrator named Uko Gorder. Major partner on this exhibit was the United States Navy, because they've been funding bioacoustic research for a long time, since the late 40s. So they've put together some learning panels over there, focusing on bioacoustics, focusing on research in the water to learn more about these animals, because more we know about them certainly helps them to know, be able to separate them out from man-made sounds in the ocean, which is certainly important for our national defense. One way of using art as an educational tool when talking about science concepts is to create something like we have here with those whale flukes. So we go from smaller to larger, none of which is very small, even the back end of the bottlenose whale there. But it really gives you a sense of how big these animals can be and what it takes to propel them through the water. Coming to the front of the animal, we have this great sculpture right here of a North Atlantic right whale, a model made here in Massachusetts. It's a life-size head, mouth wide open. You notice this baleen whale doesn't have any baleen in the front. It has its own style of filter feeding. Enormous tongue there as well. And then this big thing right here in front is life-size model of a heart of a 100-foot blue whale. You know, it's amazing that any animal can have a heart this large pumping 1,400s a gallon of blood, while only pumping 8 to 10 times a minute. And then, of course, we have our fantastic skeletons above us, none of which came to us because of the whaling industry. We have a couple of accidental deaths and a mysterious death from the early 30s, but whaling here was done in 1925. So if you're ever in New Bedford, Massachusetts, please come to the New Bedford Whaling Museum. This gallery space is always open for free. So come on and check this fantastic stuff out. Hope to see you soon.